Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because we know that the testing of our faith develops perseverance in us. Thanks, Sarah. That was James 1:3. Anyway, so how are you guys doing today?
Great.
That's awesome. So I have a question for you. Do we ever question the presence of God? Sometimes we as humans find ourselves hurt by an act or person, and we are confused, and we blame God most of the time. This feeling is caused by a death of a loved one or some type of other disaster that disrupts our own little world. And when people's little worlds are disrupted, that is when we are most insecure and vulnerable. When people are insecure because their whole world has been overturned, we begin to look for someone to blame. And when doing that, we normally first look at the person who wronged us, but what if what happened was out of human control? Well, then most of the time, we blame God. We ask God all these questions, like, why would you let this happen, or why do I deserve this? Why me? And if we let him, Satan will put a seed of doubt in your minds, and we will begin saying things like, if there even is a God, then why did we stop this? Or, if there is a God, why would he let this happen? We tend to look at the more negative side of whatever is going on. But there's more to a circumstance than a negative side. I'm a firm believer that God makes all things work together for the good of those who serve him. This means that even though it may seem dark now, when God turns back on the light, it will be on so much brighter than it ever was before. Now, believing things will always turn out for the better, it's not quite as easy as it sounds, because we have no proof that they actually will turn out for the better. This believing that things will turn out for the better, despite what everyone else thinks, is called having faith. I know, faith, a term that you've all probably heard a million and a half times, and that's probably because it's true. Faith is a word derived from the Latin word fidere, which means to trust. The definition of faith is a confidence or trust in the achievement of God's will, even though it is unseen and unexpected by everyone else. You hear that? God is calling us to have faith in him. That means we have to trust that he will make things turn out better than they are right now. Faith is more than a belief. It elevates a person, while a belief is simply a mental state or an emotion that you feel towards something. Faith inspires people to try harder, adding in confidence that things will get better despite the circumstance. Faith is our power to ignore the devil and all of his shenanigans. Not having faith during trying circumstances can lead to fear, anxiety, stress, depression, and sometimes even it'll tear down our confidence. So let's face it, whether we realize this or not, Satan is always pulling us in the opposite direction of God and throwing huge obstacles in our way. So it may seem like there's no way to get to where we need to be. And we start to lose sight of God completely. There is this seemingly impermeable shield of doubt that is around us, and we feel like maybe, just maybe, there's a God out there somewhere, but we have absolutely no idea what we are supposed to do to get back to where we need to be. This is Adam said one time during a Bible study, a winter of life. Just as there are ups and downs in life, there are ups and downs in our spiritual walk. Many of us, when we hit those low places or just want to give up right then and there, but God has bigger plans for that painful circumstance than to make us suffer. God is not some wrathful tyrant sitting up there on a cloud laughing at us while we suffer. Our God is a God of mercy, and it is during those low and confusing times that God is holding us tighter than ever. Our God strives to bring us back to that peace and joy that only he can give us. God does have reasoning behind everything, even though we may not see it. And we may never notice it, they were hurting, bad breakup, divorce, addiction, really anything that put you in pain. Okay, so we see a bad circumstance, or winter of life. Now think really hard. Was a new relationship formed? Did you learn to persevere? Did you learn anything from that painful experience? Maybe it gave you an opportunity later on down the road to relate to someone else who was going through the same things. These are just a few of the ways that God can turn something bad into something amazing. And there are so many more. An example of this is found in the crucifixion of Jesus. I mean, being beaten and mocked and forced to carry his own crossbeam on his bloody shoulders to the very place where the same people he had fellowshipped with just days before jeered at him, called him names, eventually crucifying him, and even his best of friends denied even knowing him. Talk about bad circumstances. These were horrible. But God turned things around. The story of Jesus didn't end on Friday, and neither does yours. The death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ has continued to influence the world and will continue forever. Everything you can possibly be going through right now, Jesus himself and hundreds of thousands of other people before you have gone through. So even if it feels like you're completely alone, and God is nowhere to be found, God is right there holding you tighter than ever to him. So when you come back to the bond will be so much stronger. There are times in life when you will feel down, and there are also times when you won't, and that's okay. You will find that you will go through many seasons in your life. Maybe you don't particularly like the season you're in now, but rest assured that God has a purpose for each season of your life. Be faithful and enjoy where God has you now, and before long, seasons will change. There's a time for everything, and a season for every activity under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build back up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. What does the worker gain from his toil? I have seen the burden of God has laid on men, and he has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the hearts of men, yet they cannot even begin to fathom what God has done from beginning to end. I know that there is nothing better for men than to be happy and do good while they live, that everyone may eat and drink and find satisfaction in their toil. This is a gift from God. I know that everything God does endures forever. Nothing can be added to it or taken away. Ecclesiastes 3:1-14. Let us pray. Dear God, even though we may have circumstances that are painful and we don't know how to get through them, just help us to have faith.